So students, I think some of you are taking class from the beginning or what is new. So as you know, we are discussing human genetic disorder. So in this continuation from the very beginning of the human genetic disorders, in the last class you have started mutational, and in mutational you have completed the sex linked diseases. That we have completed, and I have given some problem just for recalling. I am telling you that you have done it. In sex-linked diseases, we have done two diseases, that is blood blindness and hemophilia. Again, it will come. We have to discuss it again when we will start something called as pedigree. So from this pedigree, the question is oftenly asked from the pedigree analysis that we will do after completion of other diseases. This is one of the pedigree analysis is one of the important for KBPY. So this part we have done. We have given the list. If any student is new, please take the list from the office or see the previous lectures. Today we have to do mutational autosomal disorders. We have already given it list also. If the students who are doing the class from the very beginning have the list. Of any student is new, can take from the office, that every detail is there if you will see the previous lecture. Now, in mutational autosomal disorders, there are two categories: dominant and recessive. And I have explained the meaning of what is the dominant and what is the meaning of recessive, that I have also explained. So in the recessive, I have given the list, and from this recessive disease, we are going to discuss first sickle cell anemia. I am not writing the list again, just to recall, I told you that these things we have done. So we will start from this one, as is from the sickle cell anemia. Now, for you, start writing from here. Sickle cell anemia. So, in general, anemia means general word is loss of blood. But what is the meaning of sickle cell anemia? You know, meaning. The normal shape of the RBC is disc-shaped. And it carries the oxygen. Yeah, that you know, it carries the oxygen. So what happens, this area, it reacts with its hemoglobin to form hemoglobin. But in sickle cell anemia, what happens? the shape of RBC. Become sickle-like. Sickle is an instrument through by which we cut the crops. So in this case, the RBC become like this. This is the sickle-celled RBC. Then what will happen? The oxygen carrying capacity become negligible from here. And person will suffer from lack of oxygen. So first in sickle cell anemia, the shape of the RBC becomes sickle-shaped. Now the question arises, if it is asked which chromosome is responsible for sickle-celled anemia. The first thing, chromosome number 11. In objective, it may be asked which chromosome number is responsible for sickle cell anemia. Your answer will be 11. Because according to the, in the school, you have the your roll number. Likewise, the human chromosome also have been given their roll number, a specific roll number. So now it is okay. Now this chromosome is responsible. Now the question arises, what it causes, why it becomes sickle cell. So I think you have noted. If you have not noted it, you can take the screenshot to save the time, as I am telling you from the very beginning. So if you have taken, I am coming on the another part. What is the cause? Cause of sickle cell anemia. So you know, in hemoglobin, that is the beta chain. It consists of a different number of amino acids. This is indicating amino acids. It is chain like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. After going through the biomolecules detail, I will tell you about the amino acid. If you know, then it's okay. So in normal RBC, RBC at position number 6, there is glutamic acid. Glutamic acid is a name of amino acid. I think you are aware. Or you will, in another chapter, you will also cross in the 11th class. You will find this name in your 11th, page number 204, last para, in another reference, not in this reference. If you all have any problem in knowing amino acid, that I will clarify in the biomolecules. These are indicating the amino acid. If is it clear, then it's okay. Okay. If we don't have this idea, then I will explain. So in normal, what happens at position number 6, there is a glutamic acid. When glutamic acid is replaced by, when glutamic acid is replaced by another amino acid, valine. I think you all are aware if you have done your biomolecules. So if in position there is a valine, then the RBC cannot maintain inside. is saved and become sickle cell. Glutamic acid is replaced by valine. The shape of RBC become sickle cell. So if it is asked in the objective, which of the following is true about sickle cell anemia? Which of the following is true about sickle cell anemia? You may be given many options, but you have to tick the option at position number 6, glutamic acid is replaced by valine. So one student is asking, sickle cell RBC is harmful. I'm coming on that. That part you have to do. Of course, it is harmful in homozygous condition, death takes place. I'm coming on that point. Because you know there will be lack of oxygen. You know the function of RBC to carry oxygen, and it depends upon its shape. If it has become this one, so its surface area become different and it cannot carry the oxygen. So of course it affects, adversely it affects. So in option, you may be given which of the following is true or the cause of sickle cell anemia, then you will find that at position number 6, glutamic acid is replaced by valine. From this whole concept, you may be asked, any of you can tell where valine is written in your book 11th class? Any student remember, it is in the chapter number 9. You can find its name if you have gone in the 11th class. It is given on your page 144, first or second para, depending upon your edition. First or second paragraph, you will find valine as a neutral amino acid. Because I am not sure that you have done the biomolecules or not. So while you are preparing for KBPY, the concept from other part is always required. That's why I'm asking. Yes, in biomolecules, I have written the page. It is given as a neutral amino acid. That is another reference. So why I am asking? Because I am not very much sure that you have done or not. Either they are neutral, acidic, basic, amino acids are given, because for each and every chapter, concept of biomolecule is always required. That's why I'm checking. If you feel any problem, you will tell me, then I will give you the concept of that. So now I'm coming on another part. So from here, we have derived one question and I'm coming on another part. As I told you, the chromosome number 11 is responsible for, because its gene for RBC, for basic hemoglobin formation present here. Here it get defected. It get defected where? In the DNA. So again, I can discuss at that basis, but you have to tell, do you know about DNA or not? Otherwise, you will do another question. In the previous lecture, I told you that concept of DNA is required. Even you feel difficulty, then I will do its chemistry also. I am coming on another part. So what happens, individual, its gene is called as, hemoglobin gene is called as HB, represented by HB. Hemoglobin gene. What do you mean by gene? Gene is nothing but a segment of DNA responsible for one character. It's called gene. The definition of gene, if you want to see, you can't see in 12th class, page 72. So it's, if the individual is normal, then it is represented as HBA. And it means 100% RBC normal. Okay. Here I will give you a little bit mathematical question to solve to come on the objective. Number two. Suppose only one chromosome get defected. Suppose it is get defected. This chromosome is okay. Then what will be happen? Then you will represent like this. HBA, but it is normal. And HBS, S stands for sickle cell. So what will happen in this condition? This chromosome will produce 50% normal RBC. And this will produce 50% sickle cell RBC. So what will happen to this? This individual will survive. But remain anemic. Throughout the life. Because due to defect in gene, if you are giving the iron or vitamins, will not affect anymore because DNA is itself affected. So it's 50% RBC will work or 50% will remain sickle celled. If you analyze it blood and see in the slide under the microscope, you can see it. If you will examine it. This is called as, such an individual is called as heterozygous. I will raise question from this word. Heterozygous means one is normal, another is not. Then it is called as heterozygous. And third category, if both become affected, then it is represented by HBS and HBS. So in this condition, 100% RBC become sickle celled, so normally no survival. So in the modern technology, there is some management has been done that we will discuss later on, that bone marrow transplantation is done nowadays, but that will be done later on. This is the, in the modern era, by changing the bone marrow, it is being treated. But we will come in that part in the later on. Here, I will give you, just I'm giving you the question for making objective. This individual is normal, it is heterozygous, and it is 100% sickle cell. Is it okay? I think you all have recorded it.
सर ये थर्ड कंडीशन के लिए कोई अलग से उसका नाम नहीं है
नो इट इज कंप्लीटली सिकल सेल इट इज कॉल्ड कंप्लीटली सिकल सेल
ओके
कंप्लीट अभी तो क्वेश्चंस आपको मैं दूंगा कंप्लीट सिकल सेल अब आई विल टेल अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग ये नेचर ने इसको क्यों बनाया दैट आई विल टेल यू लेटर ऑन बिकॉज इट इज फाउंड इन द अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज मैक्सिमम ऑल्सो इन इंडिया बट मोर फ्रीक्वेंसी इन द अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज दैट स्टोरी आई एम टेलिंग यू फर्स्ट यू सॉल्व इट आई थिंक यू हैव नोटेड इट नाउ आई एम राइटिंग द क्वेश्चन बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू यूज दिस वर्ड And then later I will put on pedigree, that is another part, and every year almost question is asked from the disease and pedigree. So after completion of all genetic disorders, I will come on the pedigree. Right now I am not doing pedigree. Now write the question. A male who is heterozygous for sickle cell anemia get married with female who is also heterozygous for the same. Find out the frequency of this disease in progeny. Just I am calling you, telling you to find out the frequency, but in your exam it will be percentage will be given A, B, C, D. That I am coming on later on. First you try to solve. I am giving you 1 minute, then I will make here and you will draw. Again, I repeat my question. A male who is heterozygous for sickle cell anemia get married with female who is also heterozygous. I think you know the meaning of heterozygous. Then find out the frequency of the disease in the progeny. Means what will be the percentage of the normal or heterozygous or sickle cell. So you take 2 minutes, 120 seconds. Try to solve. Then we will make objective. I have just paused the screen, sharing of the screen. I am making it. So you have done, but you tell me what is one, what is two, what is one. I think we have done right way. HBA and HBS get married with HBA HBS, right? So there will be two types of gamete of this. I think one of you have done well, but you have to do in detail first. HBA and HBS. So it will be HBA and HBA. I think it is completely, you know, normal. HBA and HBS. Here HBA, HBS. In early you have to, it will take time, but after practice you will do within few seconds. HBS, HBS. Of what is the analysis? See here. It is completely normal. What is the question? Yes, it is. It is this, but what will be the phenotype you have to write? You have to write normal 25%, heterozygous 50%, complete sickle celled, this have you have to write 25%. Yeah, this one, see here, these two are heterozygous. This is heterozygous, this is normal, and this is completely sickle cell. So in the objective KVPI, you will not ask to calculate this one. You will be given question, in which get married, then which of the following statement is correct or incorrect? Correct or incorrect? Anything can be asked. So you have to find here the normal will be 25%, heterozygous is 50%, and completely sickle cell 25%. And then another type of interesting question, the percentage of survival will be percentage of survival. If it is us, not this one, survival, then what happens? This in completely sickle cell do not survive for a long time. Now, I'm not after giving treatment nowadays, they survive, but not on your basis. So it will not survive. So survival will be 75%. Again, one part is left that we will do in the last, explain on the basis of pedigree. So this is the answer. So you may be given another type, a normal get married with HBA and HBS. That could be a question, normal with heterozygous. Theoretically, you may be given HBA, HBA married with HBS, HBS. This theoretically it could be given, but these do not survive at the age of marriage. So you have to check it. Okay. Yes, right. And now the question arises, another interesting thing. Why it happens mostly in African countries? It is prevalent in African country. The answer is, as a sickle cell anemia is found as a natural selection. Nature has adopted this disease, that we will discuss. Why nature has adopted this disease? They brought a change in the DNA. I'm not writing the change in DNA because I'm not sure that you all have done this whole DNA chemistry. That's why I'm not coming on that point. Later I will come. So why nature has selected this disease in the population? Because, you know, in the African countries, there is more infection of malaria. You know, malaria is prevalent, and malaria is due to the infection of a protozoan Plasmodium. Plasmodium is a protozoan. Tarpogem, vivax, malaria, anything that you will study. Short life cycle you will study in the 12th class. So what happens, this Plasmodium, when enters in the body through the mosquito, that is Anopheles, that you have to study in the latter again, Anopheles mosquito bites and the Plasmodium comes. So first it comes in the liver, that's okay. After infecting the liver, this comes on the RBC. This Plasmodium comes in the RBC and breaks it. ग्रेजुअली दिस एनीमिया टेक्स प्लेस, इट हैपेंस इन द मलेरिया. बट दिस प्लाज्मोडियम कैन नॉट ग्रो इन द सिकल सेल्ड आरबीसी. प्लाज्मोडियम कांट ग्रो और एंटर एन सिकल सेल्ड आरबीसी. So the heterozygous person HBA and HBS is there that survive well in the malaria infected area, because if the plasmodium enters the sickle cell RBC, due to sickle cell RBC plasmodium cannot grow and it escapes from the malaria. So if the objectivity is asked, the sickle cell anemia is an example of, then one of the answer is natural selection. And this is selected at a natural selection to escape from malaria. Two types of objective can be derived from here. Always during discussion, you should write the objective. From sickle cell anemia or the sickle cell anemia. Defends the growth of plasmodium. So again, it will be discussed in the evolutionary point of view. But why I am discussing it more, because there are certain diseases from where the question is raised. After completion of disease, you will also discuss the blood group systems, where oftenly they raise the question from that. So, another type of question, which of the following is not true about sickle cell anemia? So, what is the true? Number one, it is an example of autosomal recessive disease. Chromosome number 11 get affected in.
Sir, only chromosome number 11 get affected in this case.
Yes. Already, see what happens. Different chromosome, different part is responsible. अभी मैं दूसरा disease discuss करूँगा, cystic fibrosis, उसमें chromosome number 7. और when you will come on Human Genome Project, उस समय मैं आपको बताऊँगा इस हर chromosome के different part is responsible for different function. तो फॉर सिकल सेल एनीमिया वो भी यहां पार्ट होती है, अपर पार्ट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल ऑलवेज, नॉट अदर. क्रोमोसोम 11 गेट अफेक्टेड, इट इज अ एग्जांपल ऑफ नेचुरल सिलेक्शन. और दिस इज द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. One any wrong statement could be given. So if it is asked which of the following is incorrect about sickle cell anemia, so this is the correct statement. Suppose up in place of 11, if it is right 7th, so ye wrong ho jayega. Is type ki questions aate. The certain part from the sickle cell anemia is left, वो अलग chapters के साथ होगा, फिर होगा. फ्रॉम द वेरी फर्स्ट क्लास आई एम टेलिंग यू इट इज एन सिस्टमैटिक स्टडी. तो जो बच्चे रेगुलर से कर रहे हैं उनका ठीक चल रहा है आई थिंक. और ये जो बीच में करेंगे तो फिर उनको फिर पूरा पीछे का देखना ही पड़ेगा. एनीवे अब नेक्स्ट कम ऑन द अनदर डिजीज थैलेसीमिया. थैलेसीमिया इट इज आल्सो ए ब्लड रिलेटेड प्रॉब्लम डिजीज. इट इज आल्सो ब्लड related diseases. Again, I would like to recall your biomolecules that you have studied in the hemoglobin. About the hemoglobin biomolecules, में आपका दिया हुआ है hemoglobin are four chains. अल्फा अल्फा बीटा एंड बीटा फोर पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन होते हैं. अभी हमने सिकल सेल एनीमिया डिस्कस किया जो यहाँ के कारण था बीटा चेन में. दैट इज आल्सो एन स्टेटमेंट. अब यहाँ देखिए वी आर कमिंग ऑन थैलेसीमिया और यू हैव टू रिकॉल दिस चैप्टर नंबर 9 ऑफ योर 11th क्लास. हीमोग्लोबिन कंसिस्ट ऑफ फोर पॉलीपेप्टाइड polypeptide chain. I think some of you might be remembering it. और यदि ये आपको याद है तो इसमें each one carry one iron. ये भी साइड में एक्स्ट्रा देखते जाए आप. सिर्फ one hemoglobin ये can carry four oxygen at a time. One hemoglobin can carry four oxygen at a time. ये भी स्टेटमेंट हो गई आपकी बायोमोलिक्यूल्स की. और ये आपकी शायद 151 पेज पर आपका लास्ट में दिया है 11th क्लास. इफ डू नॉट रिमेंबर यू हैव टू नोट इट डाउन. चार चेन होते हैं अल्फा अल्फा बीटा बीटा. तो अब इसकी जरूरत क्यों पड़ गई? बिकॉज मुझे थैलेसीमिया डिस्कस करनी है. दिस इज द बेस. तो इट इज आल्सो ड्यू टू हीमोग्लोबिन. ब्लड रिलेटेड भी है. इट इज आल्सो ड्यू टू हीमोग्लोबिन. अब इनमें डिफरेंसेस अब क्या है यहां पर? तो अब इन थैलेसीमिया टू क्रोमोजोम्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल. क्रोमोजोम नंबर 11 एंड 16. अब ये ऑब्जेक्टिव हो गया. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग क्रोमोजोम्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर थैलेसीमिया. 11 एंड 16. अब सिकल सेल एनीमिया में क्या हुई थी? तो बीटा चेन के डिफेक्टेड. बट इन थैलेसीमिया में ये ड्यू टू अल्फा चेन भी हो सकती बीटा चेन भी हो सकती. तो इफ इट इज ड्यू टू अल्फा चेन और ड्यू टू बीटा चेन ये सारे डिजीज धीरे धीरे आगे बढ़ेंगे आपको डिपेंडिंग अपॉन ग्रेजुअल नॉलेज. यदि अल्फा चेन इफेक्टेड होती है इट इज कॉल्ड एज अल्फा थैलेसीमिया. और थैलेसीमिया माइनर और बीटा में होती है इट इज कॉल्ड एज बीटा थैलेसीमिया. और थैलेसीमिया मेजर. तो देर आर If you will go in the more details, that will, it is not required for you, 30 types, but you have to know only two types. Thalassemia minor and thalassemia major. अब इसमें होते क्या है, तो अब इसमें क्या हुई थी, सिकल सेल एनीमिया में देयर वाज अ डिफेक्ट इन वन एमिनो एसिड, दैट इज ग्लूटामिक एसिड के बदले वैलिन आ गई थी, बट यहां द होल टोटल गेट चेंज्ड। एंड वन थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू टेल, इफ द चाइल्ड बोर्न विद द थैलेसीमिया मेजर, इनके साइन कम्स फ्रॉम द वेरी अर्ली स्टेज, कोई क्योर नहीं, और ये थैलेसीमिया मेजर इज अ वेरी डेडली डिजीज, एवरी मंथ इट requires blood transfusion. Every month they require blood transfusion, और इसके बाद भी और with the medicine they cannot survive more than 18 to 20 years. But it can be prevented, cannot be cured, but can be prevented just by simple test of the male and female. So one thing can be asked, what is the basic difference between the sickle cell anemia and thalassemia? So in thalassemia, is a quantitative problem. Quantitative problem means quantity of protein or amino acid, but ye quantitative word aa gaya, quantity se number of few globulin gene, or sickle cell anemia is a qualitative problem. क्वालिटेटिव मतलब क्या, क्वालिटी यानी ग्लूटामिक एसिड के बदले में वैलिन आ गई, और यहां पर टोटल चेंज जो अल्फा या बीटा है टोटल चेंज आ जाएगी, और अगेन इट, मैं बार बार कह रहा हूं, इट विल बी कम अगेन इन अदर रेफरेंस। अभी एक और डिजीज अभी आपको डिस्कस कर देता हूं थोड़ा सा, सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस।
सर थैलेसीमिया में क्या होता है हमारे ब्लड में?
थैलेसीमिया में अब जैसे इसमें हुई थी आपकी, जो एक ग्लूटामिक एसिड के बदले वैलिन आ गया, इनकी सिकल सेल जो है वो ये सिकल सेल हो गई।
यस सर।
पर थैलेसीमिया में टोटल एमिनो एसिड जो है क्वांटिटी हो जाएगा, टोटल एमिनो एसिड, टोटल ब्लड जो है दैट इज यूजलेस इन एक्सपेक्टेड इन द मेजर, यानी पार्ट से हर महीने ब्लड देना है, इनका ब्लड बेकार है।
ओके सर।
अब इनमें देखो, अब इसमें क्या बोल रहा है, जब मैं आगे आऊंगा तो इस पर और डिस्कशन होगी। तो अब इसमें क्या है, माइनर में दे कैन सर्वाइव, माइनर में थोड़ा सर्वाइवल है भी, मेजर में कोई सर्वाइवल नहीं, और इफ यू विल कम ऑन द मॉडर्न डे, तो अब सब में थोड़ी थोड़ी मॉडर्न में आई है, तो बोन मैरो ट्रांसप्लांटेशन जो मैं बायोटेक वाली पार्ट में करूंगा थोड़ा बता देता हूं। बोन मैरो ट्रांसप्लांटेशन, अपने पूछ लिया तो मैं थोड़ा बता दूं, क्योंकि मैं आप बता दो जी, ब्लड सेल्स जो बनती है वो बोन मैरो में, देखो ये हड्डियां हैं, इनके बीच फ्लूइड होती है, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज बोन मैरो। यदि आप नॉन वेज हैं तो आप नोटिस क्या होगा, इनसाइड द बोन एक फ्लूइड होता है,
यस सर,
कॉल्ड एज हाँ बोन मैरो। तो ये बोन मैरो जो है इट इज ए साइट फॉर ब्लड सेल फॉर्मेशन, ब्लड यही बनती है। तो एक्चुअल में ये डिजीज तो यहां पर राइज होती है, ये राइज तो यहां हो रही है। तो इन न्यू डिजाइन में अब ये है, इनको हटा के फिर आप इसको डोनर का यदि ट्रांसफर करते हैं करेक्ट वाला, तो इनके आजकल थोड़ी सी सर्वाइवल होती है। तो दिस पार्ट, ये जो पार्टेज है, ये पार्ट यदि आप इस पर पूछोगे तो ये मैटर चली जाएगी बायोटेक्नोलॉजी पार्ट में।
सर ऐसे तो बहुत ब्लड लगता होगा फिर तो डोनर के लिए।
नहीं नहीं ब्लड नहीं लगता, ब्लड डोनर हाँ, ब्लड जब ब्लड डोनेट होते हैं तो उनका फिक्स्ड है इतना यूनिट लगेगा, वो तो फिक्स्ड देना ही देना है, इट्स वेरी ग्रेट प्रॉब्लम। लेकिन बोन मैरो में क्या होती है, एक ही बार ट्रांसफर होती है। तो इधे पार्ट आपको बायोटेक्नोलॉजी में फिर आप रेज करेंगे क्वेश्चन, तो कैसे होता है। अभी हम जेनेटिक डिजीज में है, आपको अच्छी क्वेश्चन आ रही है दिमाग में, नोट करके छोड़ दे, तो यहाँ बताएंगे जो आखिर यहाँ क्या होती है और कौन कौन से डिजीज बोन मैरो ट्रांसप्लांटेशन से ठीक हो रही है, वो तो अलग पार्ट होगा। हम लोग अभी फोकस कर रहे हैं डिजीजेस पर, तो ठीक है। अब एक इसको भी मैं अगली क्लास में अब कैरी करूंगा, ये सेवेंथ क्रोमोसोम के कारण होता है सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस, और सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस जो है इसमें ये भी क्यूरेबल नहीं है। ये जितनी डिजीज आपको मैं जेनेटिकल बता रहा हूं ये सब में कोई भी क्यूरेबल डिजीज नहीं है। तो अब आपके टाइम हो रहे, अदरवाइज यू कैन रेज एनी क्वेश्चन। आप अपनी तरफ से कहीं से क्वेश्चन पूछना चाहते हैं तो आप पूछ लें।
सर आपने बताया था अभी अफ्रीका में ज्यादातर वो होती है सिकल।
हाँ, देखो वहां पर मच्छर ज्यादा होते हैं, मलेरिया वहां पर एनोफिलीज होती है ज्यादा अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज में। अब मैप देखेंगे तो वहां से बचने का उपाय ये नेचर ने क्या क्या अपने आप यहाँ पर डीएनए, जिसको हम लोग पढ़ेंगे म्यूटेशन में, अभी ज्यादा नहीं बता रहा था मैं आपको। म्यूटेशन का मतलब होता है चेंज। तो जब नेचुरल यहाँ अफ्रीका में यहाँ मलेरिया हो रहा है, तो ये जो मलेरिया है दैट इज के केसेस में क्या होती है, तो आरबीसी के अंदर में प्लाज्मोडियम चले जाते हैं, प्लाज्मोडियम।
तो सर इसीलिए नेचर ने उसमें सिकल सेल्स ज्यादा दे दिए, मतलब
हाँ, जब ये इनकी शेप बदल जाती है तो इसमें घुस नहीं पाते ये।
यस सर,
हेट्रोजाइगस में क्या हुआ, ये इनको बचा लिया, इसलिए ये एग्जांपल है नेचुरल सिलेक्शन का। नेचर ने सिलेक्ट किया जो कैसे बचाना है, तो उसमें कुछ फ्रीक्वेंसी को डिजीज हुआ और कुछ को उसने बचा लिया। तो हेट्रोजाइगस कंडीशन में एचबीए और एचबीएस में इंडिविजुअल मलेरिया से बच गया।
यस सर,
ये नेचर, डॉक्टर इधर कोशिश करते हैं, नेचर ने इधर बचाया है। तो सिलेक्शन दो तरह की होती है, नेचुरल सिलेक्शन एंड आर्टिफिशियल सिलेक्शन। तो ये नेचुरल सिलेक्शन, तो फिर जब मलेरिया की इनकी लाइफ साइकिल आप पूरी पढ़ेंगे तो और अच्छे से समझ में आएगा जो आखिर क्या हो गई इसमें। एक क्वेश्चन और भी आ जाती है आपके दिमाग में आनी चाहिए, जो 50% आरबीसी जो है ये तो नॉर्मल है जी, तो इस पर क्यों नहीं आ गया, ये इसमें नहीं जाएगा, इसमें तो घुस जाना चाहिए।
यस सर,
तो ये क्वेश्चन आपने क्यों नहीं पूछा, इसको अगले दिन आप मैं बताऊंगा, मैंने क्वेश्चन डाल दिया, ठीक है।
ओके सर,
अगले दिन मैं ना बता पाऊं आप फिर पूछेंगे।
ओके सर,
के बाद हम लोग ब्लड ग्रुप शुरू करेंगे।